Hey, what's up everyone? Morey Croson here, and we have an exciting new video for you today. It's going to be on gait mechanics, and essentially what gait is your walking mechanics. And as you're walking, you go through different phases as you're landing and as your feet are toeing off. And these are things that we've kind of lightly went into when doing some sprint breakdowns. But I thought today, since it's a very important assessment tool for me, when I look at my sprinters, I thought it would be very important for you guys to be able to get a better understanding of what gait is and how you can utilize it to better understand injuries and also better understand performance for athletes. So as always, if you like the information, go ahead and click the thumbs up down below. That really helps us out a lot. And subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And if you have any questions, comments, recommendations, go ahead and leave that in the comments down below. We'll go and hop in the video right now. All right, so I'm gonna start off with the strike phase of my gait here, and you can see my heel ends up touching the ground right here. And obviously it's gonna be a little bit different when it comes to walking, where, you know, when you're running, you don't wanna be hitting the ground with your heel first, but, you know, there's certain parts of being able to analyze your gait that ends up being important. You can see different types of hip shifts, you can see different types of spine rotations, maybe a different tilt in the pelvis, maybe some type of, you know, insufficient movement within the foot, maybe stuck in pronation, stuck in supination. And so being able to get an understanding of what some of these phases should look like, I think will help you in being able to identify that and then be able to fix that as a sprinter or as a sprint coach. So the first thing that's happening is, you know, obviously striking with my left foot. And as I'm striking with the left foot, I'm also simultaneously kind of shifting my weight forward with my right foot. I wanted to show you guys a little bit more of the left here, just because it's a little bit clearer in terms of what's happening. So you can see my left foot is striking. And then once all three of the tripods, which end up being like the ball of your foot, the outside part of your foot, and then the heel, when all three of those hits the ground, that ends up being the beginning of the suspension phase of the, you know, left foot, right? And then simultaneously when there's a kind of suspension phase going on, it's also when there's the propulsion phase of the right foot, which is essentially coming off, pushing off the ground with the right foot. And then once you see my left foot go into supination, so right now I'm more in like a pronated position. Once I start to supinate, which is right about there, right? So see how my weight kind of shifts to the left there. Okay, so that ends up going into the transition phase, right? So now my weight is transitioning onto the outside part of my left foot, and you can see I'm initiating the swing phase with my right foot, right? And now as my leg is swinging here and I get to the point where I'm going to actually strike the ground with my right foot, sorry, I'm in super slow motion here, but as I'm gonna go and hit the ground with my right foot, now I am shifting my weight. You can see my left heel is now coming off the ground. I'm now shifting my weight towards my right side, and now I'm striking on the right foot and going through again that propulsion phase on the left foot, where now I'm shifting all of my weight forward onto the front part of my foot, right? So during this initial kind of shift phase, as I'm striking the ground with my right side, my weight is shifting more so from left to right. And now I'm going to that propulsion phase where now I'm shifting more of my weight forward onto my right foot. Okay, and now as I'm going through that propulsion phase, and again, you know, as I'm my right foot's first striking, and then it's going through that initial kind of suspension phase. And the reason I wanted to show the left one a little bit better is I've sprained my ankle a good amount of times on my right side. You can see my right ankles are very, very kind of bulging, and so it's a lot harder to be able to see that kind of suspension phase on my right side as I begin to shift there. You know, I don't really get into very much of a supinated position. I kind of stay a little bit more pronated on my right foot, which is a great thing to be able to assess on me and be able to get a better understanding of what's going on within my body, because I stay, and you can even see how thick my right ankle is, the inside part of my right ankle in comparison to the left side. You know, and that kind of makes it a little bit harder, I think, for my foot to be able to properly go into supination on that right side. So, you know, that ends up obviously impacting certain parts of dorsiflexion landing on my right side, and, you know, something that you can go and, you know, really assess in anybody. So, you know, now as I'm going through the swing phase, I'm also going through that same type of transition onto the right side, where now all of my weight is shifted onto obviously my right side. And then once my left foot hits again, Now I'm going to be beginning that time of shifting my weight back to my left and then shifting my weight forward onto my left leg and then going into that propulsion where now I'm pushing off my right foot and then going through that swing phase. So just being able to get a good understanding of what should be happening within the feet gives you, again, a good understanding of, you know, where there might be some type of dysfunction. Like for me, you could obviously see that lack of going into supination on my right side, and then there ends up being different types of supination that goes in to better understanding that from there. Now, real quickly, I just wanna go into some of the spiral lines that are impacted at this time. So the spiral lines is something that is developed by Thomas Myers, great book, Anatomy Trains. If you haven't seen it, then you should definitely check that out. And essentially what it goes into is, you know, when different parts of your body are interacting or you know, active, you know, what that all impacts. So there's like a back line, which is your calves and your hamstrings and your lower back. And so all those muscles form a line of fascia that ends up being all interconnected, right? I know that when you are working, like isometrically working your hamstrings, you're not necessarily, you know, working a ton on like the calves or the lumbar spine, but when you're actually active and doing, you know, different types of movements, jumping, things like that, when you're using your calves, you're also using your hamstrings, you're also using your lower back, there's like a whole fascia of muscles that are interconnected that are firing at the same time, and that would be the back line. And then there's a front line, you know, all the muscles of your core and your quads, the hip flexors, the dorsiflexors of your ankles. And then there's a lateral line that moves side to side, and then there's a spiral line that transitions kind of across through your body. And all these things end up being very, very important when it comes to being able to run and being able to understand what is important when you're running. So, you know, going deep into the fascial lines, what's happening during, you know, that initial strike of a foot is that you're actually activating that superficial back line, which is going to be, again, all of your you know, like the flexor hallucis on the back of the leg there, your hamstrings, your lumbar erectors, those are all going to be active during that time. And then that's also what's going to be, and then what's going to be also active at that same time is going to be the front line of your push-off leg. So as I'm going in and, you know, shifting my weight forward off my left foot, now my front line is active on my left side and my back line is active on my right side. So there seems to be this kind of relationship where when you're using more of one part of your body, you're also, you know, kind of taking away from the or you're using the opposite part of the other side of your body. So back line on the right side, front line on the left side. And then we're going to go into that suspension where now all three tripods of the foot are down onto the ground. And now this is going to be in the lateral line. So this is where I'm going to be kind of stabilizing within the that front leg, right? And then on the left side, it's going to be more of the superficial front line. So, you know, as I transition from, you know, utilizing more of the muscles that are going to be like the abs and, you know, the hip flexors, that's when I'm going to also be using the lateral line on the right side, where when I'm using the superficial back line on the right and the deep front on the left, that's going to be more of like your adductor muscles and your deep transverse abdominals. So like the deeper frontline muscles are going to be when you're hitting the ground on the right foot and also going and shifting your weight off of your left foot onto your right foot. And then when you go through the actual push off is when you're going to be using the superficial ones, which is more of your rectus abdominis, so the more outside superficial muscles of the abs, the, you know, more superficial muscles of your hip flexors, of your quads. Again, so it's going to be more of a superficial part of that. And then you're going to go through the swing phase here, and as you're going through the swing phase, you're going to be using the spiral line both simultaneously here. So you're going to be transitioning onto your right leg, and you're going to be using the spiral line on the left side and through your right leg to be able to, the left foot all in through the right foot to be able to properly absorb that and properly get the torsional forces that you need to be able to go through the swing phase. Very important to be able to understand the spiral line and the impact that it has as you're going through that swing phase. And then you're going to go through the, again, strike on the left side, which is going to be the superficial back line on the left side, and then it's going to be the deep front line on the right side. So now we're just going over the same thing again, and then you're going to be going over to the suspension phase, which is going to be the lateral line on the left side, and then the propulsion phase on the right side, which is going to be that superficial front line. So again, more of like the quads and the superficial muscles of the abs, and then we're gonna go back as we go into the swing phase into that spiral line from the right side into the left side when you're going through this transition. So really the most important thing to be able to take away from is when you're going through that swing phase is gonna be a super important part where you need a lot of stability within, you know, the opposite leg as you're going through that actual spiral transition or swing phase, and being able to understand the musculature behind that spiral line to be able to best utilize that during the swing phase, which is a very, very important phase of sprinting and a very important thing to be able to analyze when you're going through and running. So being able to see how well your hips are able to properly be utilized during that swing phase is something that's super important in terms of power development as well as in terms of developing overall speed and force from a sprinting perspective. So yeah, a lot of information here in the video. I hope that it ends up being informative for you. If you need to look into any of these words, I would highly recommend you being able to do that just to be able to get a greater understanding of this video. As always, if you have any questions for me, you could leave those in the comments down below. I want to continue to do some more videos like this that go just deeper into the science of sprinting, the science of walking, the science of being able to perform better. And I think it'll be able to provide a lot of value for you guys that have been watching and trying to learn how to improve your mechanics and get better at your sprinting. All right, as always, thanks for watching these videos. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And we have some different things in the description down below to be able to help you out with different types of free eBooks, free 5 ways to get faster. We have a free trial to our speed program. You could also join our speed program. You could also get a breakdown. There's a lot of different things you could do down below in the description. And also check out our website if you have any questions for us or want to contact us and, you know, be able to learn more about what we do. All right, thanks for watching. Talk to you soon.